نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، من يهدي الله فهو المهتد ومن يضلل فلن تجد له وليا مرشدا. وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء، واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام، إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم، ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما. أما بعد، عباد الله، اعلموا أن خير الكلام كلام الله، وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم، وشر الأمور محدثاتها، وكل محدثة بدعة، وكل بدعة ضلالة، وكل ضلالة في النار. عباد الله، for the moments that we have together for the sake of Allah in the house of Allah, I want to take you with me to a journey. And what a beautiful journey. A journey that we are going to meet our messenger Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So my dear brothers and sisters in Islam, allow me to borrow your hearts and ears. Indeed, it is a magnificent moment that we will spend together for the sake of Allah. Let us start with the hadith in Sahih Muslim. Min hadith Amr ibn Abbas radiyallahu anhu. A man by the name Amr ibn Abbas radiyallahu anhu said, Kuntu wa ana fil jahiliyyah adhunnu an-nas ala dalala wa annahum laysu ala shay fi ibadatil awthan. فسمعت برجل يخبر أخبارا فقعدت على راحلتي فدخلت مكة فإذا برسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم مستخفيا من قومي فتلطفت فدخلت عليه فقلت ما أنت؟ قال النبي. قلت وما النبي؟ قال إن الله أرسلني. قلت وبما أرسلك؟ قال بصلة الأرحام وكسر الأوثان وأن يوحد الله لا يشرك به شيئا. قلت ومن معك على هذا؟ قال حر وعبد، وكان معه يومئذ أبو بكر وبلال. Allow me to translate with the limited ability and to articulate with the disability of language that I have about the hadith of a Nabi, what this man say with the messenger of Allah. He said, at the time of Jahiliyyah, I knew people worshipping the wrong thing, so I heard about a man in the city of Mecca speaking things that is unusual. So I sat on my mountain and I went to the city of Mecca, and I realized the man that they're talking about is the messenger of Allah who's hiding from his people. So secretly I went to him. I said to him, what are you? يا محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم What are you? He said, I am a Nabi. I said, what is a Nabi? This term is not familiar with me. He said, Allah has sent me. I said, what did He send you with? He said, He sent me with that I should tie the relationship between me and my kinship. That the idols must be destroyed and Allah should be worshipped alone. I said to him, and who is in this with you? He said, I have two followers. I have Abu Bakr as-Siddiq and I have a slave man by the name Bilal. As we know, Abu Bakr does not need introduction from us. He is a sahib al-Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. من لي بمثلك يا أبا بكر تمشي رويدا وتجيء في الأول The poet said, Who is like you, O Abu Bakr? Tell me anyone like you, Abu Bakr. Always you take your steps slowly, but you first in every occasion. But Bilal was عبد حبشي. لا يعرفه أحد, nobody knows him. A man who was not destined to have a legacy. A black Abyssinian from Ethiopia who was sold and bought by a people of Mecca whose purpose of life was to serve his master Umayyah bin Khalf. He was not to have a legacy to be remembered, but he should have lived as a slave and die as a slave. Bilal, while he was with his master Umayyah bin Khalaf, he heard that a man by the name Muhammad that was known in the city of Mecca, Al-Amin, the Sadiq Al-Amin, this man now is preaching a new religion. And of course, the city of Mecca, my dear brothers and sisters, when Allah has sent Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the environment of the city changed. The attitude of the people changed. The demeanor of the people changed. تغيرت أخلاق الناس. إن البرية يوم مبعث أحمد نظر الإله لها فبدل حالها بل كرم الإنسان حين اختار من خير البرية نجمها وهلالها. Allah changed the condition of the environment by sending Messenger Muhammad sallallahu alaihi. So Bilal, he accepted Islam. He became a mu'min. وَلَمْ يُبَالِي And he did not care about his master. But the spies and the eyes of the Quraysh were on everyone. So Umayyah learned that his slave, the man was his purpose to serve him. Now he became a follower of Muhammad. فقال يا بلال أصبعت وآمنت بدين محمد He said يا بلال You lost your way and you followed this man قال لا يا أمية No يا أمية آمنت بل أن لا إله إلا الله وأن محمد رسول الله سبحان الله قال يا بلال ارجع عن ديني Come back from his religion. قال لا. قال إذا لأجعلنك آية لكل عبد. He said, I will make you an example for every slave so they will never become Muslims. So what did they do to Bilal? They started dragging him naked on his back on the sharp rocks of the city of Mecca. They placed a rock on his chest under the heat of the Mecca. They deprived him from food and drink. They lashed him between here and there. And Umayyah with the thick umbrella protecting him from the sun, he comes down to Bilal and he says, Ya Bilal, ukfur bi Muhammad. And Bilal says, Ahadun Ahad. أحد أحد يا الله عبد Slave has no family to protect. No money. No money. No members. No one but Allah. But he took the challenge. And under that oppression, Abu Bakr passed by him. And he saw Bilal under the rock. And he says to Umayyah and Abu Bakr, Rajulun Salih, فقال يا أمية بعني بلال فلا حاجة لك به. He says, sell Bilal to me. Indeed, you have no use to him. You have no use for this man. So Umayyah, he sold to him. And then Abu Bakr, he picked his brother. He picked his brother. He didn't say, you are black. He didn't say, you are not from my race. He did not say, I am Arab and you are Ajam. He picked his brother and he took his arm around his neck and he walked away. And while he was walking away, Umayyah bin Khalaf said to Abu Bakr, and he's looking the money that he gave for Bilal. And he said, Ya Abu Bakr, indeed, you paid so much for this slave. And then Abu Bakr, he turned to Umayyah and he turned to Bilal. فَقَالَ إِنَّهُ أَخِي وَالَّذِي بَعَثَ مُحَمَّدًا بِالْحَقِّ. I swear by the one who sent Muhammad with the truth, had you asked the highest price, I would have paid him for it. Why? Why? There is no Palestinians and Ugandans and Kenyans and Somalis and Turkish. There's only Muslims. There's no Ajam and Arab. It is only us. Bilal Habashi wa Abu Bakr al-Qurayshi, ikhwan fi dinillah. No one else. In yakhtalif ma'u al-wisali fa ma'una 'adhbun tahaddara min ghamamin wahid. Aw yakhtalifu an-nasabu yu'allifu baynana deenun aqamnahu maqam al-walidi. He said, the poet said, if we think we came from a different lineage, he said, we put that aside and we put the father, we put Islam as our father. And then Bilal, he went to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And that was the best day from the days of Bilal. He's sitting with Rasulullah. And his body is ripped. He's shredded with whips. He's bleeding, but he did not feel the pain of the skin. He felt the sweetness of Iman in front of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. يقول المؤرخون, messenger of Allah hugged Bilal and Bilal hugged Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And Bilal was so pleased that now he is one of the followers of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Because nothing, wallahi there is no degree, wallahi there is no position, wallahi there is no status better than being Muslim and being from the followers of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. لذلك قال القائل ومما زادني شرفا وتيها وكدت بأخمصي أطأ الثريا دخولي تحت قولك يا عبادي وأن سيرت لي أحمد النبي. He said, the poet said, and I cannot articulate enough. He said, out of honor, I can reach the sky. My feet are reaching the sky. I'm so honored that Allah has called me, Ya Ibadi, O my slave. And Allah chose me to be Muhammad, my messenger, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Ibadallah, Rasulullah and the Sahaba migrated to Medina. And Bilal is like this with Rasulullah. When he sits, he sits. When he speaks, he listens. When he teaches, he pays attention. When he eats, he eats. And Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, every time that something bothers him, he turns towards Bilal and he says to Bilal, Arihna biha ya Bilal. Comfort us with the salah, ya Bilal. And Bilal, with his beautiful voice, he gets on the top of the roof of the masjid And he calls Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar. La ashhadu an la ilaha illallah. Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah. And the people min kulli fajjin amir, and the people of the city of Medina, the farmer leaves his farm, the businessman leaves his job, the student leaves his home, the class, everybody comes to the Masjid al-Nabi al-Salah. And then the time came for Ma'arakat Badr. And Badr was a coincidence. And the Muslims were only 300 people. And they were adhilla. لَقَدْ نَصَرَكُمُ اللَّهُ بِبَدْرٍ وَأَنْتُمْ adhilla. They were few in number, but they were many in hearts. Not like the Muslims today, that we are over 2 billion, but our brothers and sisters in Palestine have no right. Muslims those days, they had dignity and self-respect. So the day of Badr came, and the Sahaba said to the Messenger of Allah, what is the slogan of this battlefield? And the Messenger of Allah, قال اليوم شعارنا أحد 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 أحد. To honor Bilal bin Rabah رضي الله عنه. And the Sahaba, they went. والتلقى الجمعان, and the two group met. إذ أنتم الله سب العدوة الدنيا وهم بالعدوة القصوى والركب أسفل منكم ولو تواعدتم لاختلفتم في الميعاد ولكن يقضي الله أمرا كان مفعولا. And then subhanallah, the Sahaba stood against 1,000 fighters. The soldiers were not the bodies, but were the souls. The souls were the soldiers. They were the one who was fighting. من الذي رفع اسمك يا الله ليرفع اسمك فوق هامات النجوم كنا منارا في كن في فوق هامات النجوم منارا كنا جبالا في الجبال وربما سرنا على موج البحار بحارا لم تنسى إفريقيا ولا صحراء سجداتنا والأرض تقذف نارا كنا نقدم للسيوف صدورنا ولم نخشى يوما غاشما جبارا وكأن ظل السيوف ظل حديقة خضراء ينبت تحتها أزهارا. Muhammad Iqbal, the Pakistani poet, describing the scene, he said, Ya Allah, raise your name above the clouds. Ya Allah, he said, we were mountain on the top of mountains. We were waves on the top of waves, he said. He said, we used to present our chest to the sword, and we never fear a tyrant in our lives. And we used to see the shade of the sword as a garden where the flowers are blooming. And now, قَضَى اللَّهُ أَمْرًا كَانَ مَفْعُولًا. And the battlefield went down, and 70 of the mushrikeen are killed. And the Sahaba are victorious. And Abdurrahman bin Auf grabbed Umayyah bin Khalf and his son, and he tied them down, dragging towards the prisoners of war. And Bilal bin Rabah, he spotted Umayyah bin Khalf being dragged, and then he ran towards him, and then he showed his sword, and he wants to kill the man who put him under the rock. He wants to take his revenge. But Abdurrahman bin Auf said to him, Ya Bilal, innahu asiri. Bilal, he is my prisoner. You cannot touch him. And he went to the right, and Abdurrahman blocked him. And he went to the left, and Abdurrahman blocked him. And then he turned, Bilal turned to the Sahaba. Qala ya ma'ashar al-ansar. Ya ma'ashar al-ansar. Ya ma'ashar al-ansar. Aduw Allahi Umayya bin Khalaf. And they came running. Ya gharat Allah, jadda sayra musri'atan fi sahqi a'da'ina ya gharat Allah. They came running and they killed him. They killed him. And then Bilal, he raised his sword and he ran. And he said, ahadun ahad, ahadun ahad, ahadun ahad. نعم أحد أحد today أحد أحد يا عباد الله. بلال stayed under the shade of Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم until end of his life. And the next scene that we will share is فتح مكة. قولوا ما تسمعون استغفر الله لكم فاستغفروه إنه هو الغفور الرحيم. والصلاة والسلام على رسوله الكريم سيدنا ونبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. نشهد أنه بلغ الرسالة وأدى الأمانة ونصح الأمة وكشف الغمة وجاهد في الله حق جهاد حتى أتاه اليقين. فصلوات الله وسلام عليه ما تطوع مسك وفاح وما ترنم حمام وصاح وما هذل غرق وناح. عباد الله, no khatib, no speaker, no lecture can give Bilal his haqq. But I'm taking from every moment a beautiful flower. Perhaps Allah would give me the ability to share it with you. And let us go to the scene when the Messenger of Allah conquered the city of Mecca. And the Messenger of Allah is riding his mount. And هو مطأطأ الرأس. He lowered his head out of respect of the scene. He has around Mecca 360 idols. And he has his stick and he's pointing to them or pushing them. And he's reciting, وَقُلْ جَاءَ الْحَقُّ وَزَهَقَ الْبَاطِلِ إِنَّ الْبَاطِلَ كَانَ زَهُوقًا. And then the Messenger of Allah came and the people are moving aside away from Rasulullah and Abu Sufyan and the Qamamur al-Quraysh, the Jababirat al-Quraysh, the sheaf of the Quraysh, they're moving away and the Messenger of Allah is sitting directed to the Kaaba. قُلْ لِلْمُلُوكِ تَنَحَّوْا عَنْ مَنَاصِبَكُمْ فَقَدْ جَاءَ آخِرِ الدُّنْيَا. Tell the kings, it said the poet, move away from the way of the king. Indeed, the one who takes dunya gives away approach. And Uthman, Talha bin Uthman radiyallahu anhu, the Messenger of Allah said, open the gates of the Kaaba. And he entered the Kaaba. تخيلوا يا عباد الله, first time the Messenger of Allah as a victorious is entering the Kaaba. Did he bring Abu Bakr al-Siddiq to come inside the Kaaba? لا. Did he bring Uthman bin Affan? لا. Did he bring Umar bin Khattab, Ali bin Abi Talib? لا. He brought Bilal and Usama bin Zayd. He brought them in. And three of them with the Messenger of Allah, they closed the door of the Kaaba. And when they came out, and the Messenger of Allah said to the Quraysh, مَا تَظُنُّونَ إِنِّي فَاعِلٌ بِكُمْ. What do you think I'm going to do with you? They say, you are the son of the most honorable and the most honorable. And he say, go, you are indeed free. Then the Messenger of Allah asked Bilal to get on the top of the Kaaba. Ahin thumma ah. And then Bilal stood on the top of the Kaaba. يقول المؤرخون, the historian said, he stayed silent for a moment. And he looked around and he reflected and he remembered the day that he was dragged on the sharp rock on the city of Mecca. He remembers the body of Sumayyah bint Khayyat. He remembers the body of the father Ammar bin Yasir, Yasir himself. And then he looked around and he wept. But he called the Adhan. What a beautiful moment. And he said, Allahu Akbar. And the mu'mineen, they repeated after him, Allahu Akbar. And ya ibad Allah, takhayyalu. He's saying, Allahu Akbar. But where are those who were tyrant? Where is Abu Lahab? Where is Abu Jahl? Where is Umayyah bin Khalaf? Where are they? They are in Jahannam. And where is Bilal on the Kaaba al-Musharrafa? نعم يا عباد الله. This deen is now for the most strongest. This deen is now for the wealthiest. This deen is for the true believers. Let us move forward. And Hajjat al-Wada' came. And what a moment to remember. Messenger of Allah comes, left alone the city of Makkah, but he comes back with 110,000 soldiers. And then on the day of Arafah, Allah reveals, اليوم أكملت لكم دينكم وأتممت عليكم نعمتي ورضيت لكم الإسلام دينا. And then Abu Bakr and Umar, يقال عمر تنحى عمر, he stood aside. And Umar, he sat down and he wept. فقيل له, and they said to Umar, ما يبكيك, why would you weep? Allah has just revealed the perfections of our deen. And Umar said, يا عبد الله وهل بعد الكمال إلا النقصان. He said, there is nothing after perfection except the imperfection. Allah has completed our deen. We will go in decline. But nobody else felt. Al-Jamarat, the messenger of Allah, comes. He says to the Sahaba, he says to them, خذوا عني مناسككم فلعلي لا ألقاكم بعد عامي هذا. He says to them, take your rituals for me, learn. He's with them. Perhaps you will never meet me again in this place. The Sahaba didn't know what he meant. خذوا عني مناسككم فلعلكم لا تلقوني بعد عامكم هذا أبدا. So they came, and they came to back to the city of Medina. And around 28, 29 of the 11th year, and they, messenger of Allah, went for a janazah in al-Baqi' and he came back. And then he said, oh, my head hurts. And then the messenger of Allah started getting sick and is getting sicker. And he comes, he was sick between 31 to 41 difference of the opinions. And he came every day leading the salah. On the Wednesday, 5 days before his death, Messenger of Allah said to the women, to his wives, pour water in his face. Let me go to the masjid. I want to speak to my people. And they pour water in his face. And they brought him, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, to the mihrab, to the minbar. And he sat on the minbar. بِأَبِي أَنْتَ وَأُمِّي يَا رَسُولَ اللَّهِ. He tied his head with the turban so tight that the Sahaba said, we could feel the humma, the fever. We could feel the heat through the turban. And he sat on the minbar and he said to the Sahaba, مَنْ جَلَتُ لَهُ ظَهْرًا. He said, if I ever whip you wrongly, this is my back. Come on, whip with me right here. If I ever took money from you, come on, ask for it. If I ever insult you, take your right from me. And then he prayed dhuhr, and he sat back repeating the same thing. And a man said, Ya Rasulullah, you owe me 3 dirhams. Qala ya fadl, give him the man his money. But he said a hadith that the people did not understand except one. Qala inna Allah khayyara abdan. Inna Allah khayyara abdan bayna zahrat al-dunya wa ma fiha wa ma inda Allah. وَمَا عِنَّهُ فَاخْتَارَ مَا عِنَّهُ. He said, Allah has given a slave a choice to choose this dunya and everything on it or to meet his Lord. فَاخْتَارَ مَا عِنَّ اللَّهِ. But the slave, he said, he chose to meet his Lord. Abu Bakr is the only one who cried. And he said, بَلْ نَفْدِيكَ بِآبَائِنَا وَأُمَّهَاتِنَا We will sacrifice our parents for your sake. And the messenger of Allah قال, لَا تَكِّ يَا أَبَا بَكْرٍ Don't weep, يَا أَبَا بَكْرٍ إِنَّ مِنْ أَمَنِّ النَّاسِ عَلَيَّ فِي صُحْبَتِهِ وَمَالِهِ أَبَا بَكْرٍ وَلُوْ مُتَّخِنٌ خَلِيلًا دُوَ غَيْرَ اللَّهِ لَاتَّخَدْتُ أَبَا بَكْرٍ خَلِيلًا He said, nobody ever gave me his right as a companion and gave me out of his wealth like Abu Bakr as-Siddiq. And he said, if I would take anyone as a Khalil, I would have chosen Abu Bakr al-Khalil, but I am the Khalil al-Rahman, he said. And then he went back. Yawm al-Khamis, he came back and he led until Salat till Maghrib. And he said, Muru Abu Bakr fal-yusalli bin-nas. Yawm al-Jum'a did not come. Yawm al-Sabt, he just came and sat next to Abu Bakr and led the Salah. Yawm al-Ahad did not come. On Wednesday, Monday morning, this is the day, the worst day of Ummat Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. The saddest day of Ummat Muhammad is Tuesday, is a Monday of that month, Rabi' al-Awwal. On that day, in the house of Aisha, Aisha said, radiyallahu anha, she said, I was reading, قُلْ هُوَ اللَّهُ قُلْ أَعُوذُ بِرَبِّ الْفَلَقِ قُلْ أَعُوذُ بِرَبِّ النَّاسِ وَرَسُولُ اللَّهِ And I was, you know, blowing his hands and wiping them. And then she said, and he was leaning on my chest. And then she said, Abdul Rahman, my brother, came in with the miswak. And Rasulullah, he looked at the miswak. And I said to him, do you want me to take the miswak for you? She said, yeah. He said, yes. And then the messenger of Allah, he tried to soften the miswak for himself, but he couldn't. He was weak, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So Aisha said, I took the miswak, and he softened it for him, and I gave it to him. And then he used it with force. And he put it down. And then he raised his finger and he said, بل الرفيق الأعلى. الرفيق, I want to be with the most high. I want to be with the Anbiya wa Salihin wa Shuhada. And then he put his hand down and he passed away. That's the last moment she said, I held him tight. And while I was holding him tight, crying over him, Umar comes. And ask for permission, so I put my niqab and my hijab on. And I sat in the corner, not telling him that Rasulullah had just died. And then she said, with Mughira bin Shu'bah, they said, Ya Rasulullah, you look so calm. And finally they left, but Mughira said to Umar, Rasulullah, he passed away. And that's when the fitness started. Umar said, La, he cannot die. Messenger of Allah cannot die. Wallahi, whoever says he's dead, he will come back and cut their hands and feet. To make a long story short, Salat al-Dhuhr came. And Sahibuna Bilal radiyallahu anhu, every time that he wants to call the adhan, he used to hear the messenger of Allah is saying, Ya Bilal, arihna biha. But at this moment, Abu Bakr calls him and he says, Ya Bilal, call the adhan. And Bilal said, I call the adhan without Rasulullah. I cannot call the adhan. I can't call the adhan with Rasulullah. فَقَالَ أَبُو بَكْرِ يَا بِلَال Call the adhan. And then Bilal, he dragged himself and he went. And he said, Allahu Akbar. And wallahi, every human being cried in the city of Medina. Children cried. Women cried. Men cried. Because they know when the messenger, when Abu Bilal said, Ashhadu anna Muhammad al-Rasulullah, there is no more Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam alive. No more Muhammad. Bilal radiyallahu anhu, when he calls the adhan, and he turns to Abu Bakr,
وقال يا أبا بكر والله لا أؤذن لأحد بعدك today after today I will never call the Adhan for anyone.
عباد الله, I took more time than I expected. What we need to understand, Bilal was not just a slave. Bilal was a legacy that we should live by him. Bilal was not just an Abyssinian slave. Bilal taught us how to be resistant, how to persevere, how to have sabr on the difficult times. Bilal taught us there is no success without being under the shadow of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Bilal taught us, radiyallahu anhu, life is meaningless. And that's why the day that he was dying, his wife wept. And he said, لا تبكي, do not cry. غدا ألقى محمدا وصحبه. Tomorrow I will meet Muhammad and my beloved ones. That is the life we should live every single day. Wish the day that you and I will meet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. But imagine if we come today to the day of Yawm al-Qiyamah and Muhammad says to us, كما في صحيح البخاري, take them away, they are not from my ummah. Take them away, they indeed abandoned my sunnah. Take them away, they will not be part of me. So let us try our best. I'm trying to be like Bilal radiyallahu anhu. اللهم أعز الإسلام والمسلمين اللهم أعز الإسلام والمسلمين اللهم ارحمنا فأنت بنا راحم ولا تعذبنا فأنت علينا قادر اللهم يسر لنا أمورنا واهدنا إلى سبل السلام واقم الصلاة يرحمني يرحمكم الله